They're fully warmed up for the tip. Welcome, everyone, and what a game we have for you tonight. Kevin Harlan here, along with Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr, as we get set to bring you NBA action on 2K Sports. Our starting lineups, a look at the matchups here and who we'll see for our starting five for both teams. And for the home team, shot is off. 3-on-3. And taken away by Johnson. Oh, and here comes Johnson all alone.
Well, this is how you completely rattle an opponent's rip.
Yeah, you know, such terrific on-the-ball defense to trigger the transition opportunity.
And it wasn't just a tough D, it was the exclamation point they put on the fast break with the slam.
Doris Burke has some information for us. Doris?
I briefly spoke with the home team's head coach. He'd like them to concentrate defensively on slowing the game down. There's simply too much speed in their opponent, and to get into a run-and-gun type of game is not to their advantage, guys.
All right, Doris, thanks. That is good. Johnson's got 5 points so far.
Fantastic pass. He turned that one into a pretty easy basket for his teammate.
And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two. And the first one drops. He's perfect from the line this time.
There's not a lot you can say that hasn't been said before about his skill at the charity stripe.
Gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Number 33. And that one goes in as he is fouled. It'll be 3 points as he converts at the line.
And you see how easily he got around his defender there on the drive. Just too strong for him.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight.
Number 33. At the line from one.
And the free throw, no good. Number 5 takes the lead pass. Wide open look. And good on the basket. Book it. First quarter of play with about a minute and a half gone. Number 33 defended by Montgomery. That's good.
And they're nearly perfect from the floor early on. 4 of their first 5 shots they've drained.
Uncovered. The rebound by Johnson.
Can't get a much better look than that, though.
Sure can't. Not one you'd expect him to miss there.
Inside. Picked off in midair. There's 1:54 left to play here in the first. From outside the arc. And that one's good. 5 points in the game.
That's like a layup for him. He's just wide open out there.
Pass to Sutton. Let's the three fly. That's your man, Jackson, with the assist.
How about the response? Retaliation. Impressive, huh, guys?
I'll say exactly that as well. Nice job to recover those 3 points right away.
Number five hits the jumper in space. 1:16 left to play in the first quarter. Left side, Williams. Stolen away. Number five. The pass to Montgomery. Fires from 14. Gets it to go.
You're going to be waiting a long time if you're waiting for him to miss that when he's that open.
Gone two or three from deep so far in this game. Johnson outside. He dishes it to Williams. Gets it to go. Williams has got his first bucket in this one. First quarter of action, just under 3.5 minutes played. Got a piece of it. Here's the three. Good. 10 points for him.
A wide open three. They need much better communication defensively.
Gotten 6 or 7 shots to fall in the first quarter. They're off and running. Zero. And they wasted no time getting those 3 points back.
I don't know how they're going to keep this pace up. Both teams on fire here early.
And playing the game on rollerblades, too.
Zero. Misses from short range. Got it up. Can't hit. And a good game so far as we conclude the first quarter. The home team, they lead by one. And the second quarter will be on the way when we come back. Close game here as we get back to the second quarter. And guys, what's your take on the home team so far?
And you could see early on, guys, they were going to go inside and try to establish their offense in the paint area. That's exactly what they've done.
And I think that's exactly where they should continue to attack moving forward, Steve.
Number five, defended by Williamson. Tipped away. Here's the break. Number 30. Lays it in off the breakaway. And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, Doris Brook. Doris, over to you.
Yes, guys, the Brooklyn Nets going all in this season. With a team payroll of about $100 million, they have an additional luxury tax bill of around $75 million. Guys, the owner sparing no expense in constructing this roster. But no question, high burden of expectation for what they'll achieve. It's championship or bust.
No doubt about that. Thank you, Doris. And it's blocked. And they're running, pushing it up. And that goes out of bounds. And they'll keep possession. They grab their own miss. Brooks misses. Gone 3 of 5 from beyond the arc so far tonight. Number 30. Shot is blocked. Gotten only 1 of their first 4 shots in the second quarter to drop. Number 10. And that one's on target from the wing.
Wow, this has been a thriller. I mean, the way these teams are battling, just going back and forth.
Would you like to bet that this game may end on a buzzer beater? How much would you bet?
Here's Williamson. Good. Punt, a lot of give and take between these sides early.
Kevin, how about six lead changes in this half already?
Yeah, good one here. Guys, this is going to be fun to watch. Two evenly matched teams, both teams fighting hard.
There it is, guys, that Olé defense. Just watching him go, Clark, right by.
I think we might be seeing which team is ready to take control of this game.
Yeah, that's a dunk that could absolutely get them going. I agree, Clark.
Gone 2-4 shooting the ball here in the second. Pass to Perry.
2 minutes.
Let's it go. Cans the shot from the wing.
Superb assist there. He played the role of the maestro on that one.
Gone 50% from the floor in the second quarter, 3-6.
Yeah, and guys, I think he feels like he can make a few improvements during this timeout, just kind of make a couple of adjustments, get his club back on track.
You know, coaches are always tweaking and tinkering with things mid-game. Actually, sometimes they overdo it.
.49 left in the first half. That's good. It has been nip and tuck through the first half.
No kidding. I mean, neither team has been able to hold the lead for any length of time, guys.
Yeah. Steve, so close.
Well, such a seesaw affair back and forth. I mean, this has been an unbelievable game to watch.
And there's a minute 45 left now here in the second. Pass to Williamson. And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Chance here now for a three-point play.
Outstanding job there to absorb the contact and guide it in.
That's how you impose your will against the defender. He came to play.
And he's got his first chance at the line here. A free throw off from Williamson. Gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. Number 10. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up.
Well, probably the right play defensively. If you can't get the block, send them to the free throw line. Don't give them an easy two.
No easy buckets inside. Force free throws and work to keep them out of the lane next time around.
It's his first trip to the line. First one falls for him. And that one goes in. Two from the line that time. 1:30 left in the first half. Now the pass to Williamson. Here's Perry. Perry's the long-range jumper. He's got five.
How about the passing here? Moving the ball without any thought, without any agenda.
It's hard to overstate all the points they've scored on assists today. Beautiful to watch.
Gone 5-7 from the field here in the second. Let's it go with a three. That's good.
Seems like guarding him on the perimeter is not a priority for this defense, but it will become one if he continues to knock them down.
52 seconds left to play here in the second quarter. To the inside. Number one. Soft touch off the glass.
I really like the fact that he's getting the touches he needs here after not scoring a single point in that first quarter.
Number 23, Brooks covering, gets it to go.
We got a little room at
at the rim and laid it in. Great play.
Very well, 56% from the floor here in the second quarter. Boom, he jams it straight down.
Went for the two-hander on that slam. That's where the weight room comes into play, yeah, Kevin.
I think some urgency from him there.
Yeah, he's sensing this is a critical time in this game, guys.
And here in the second quarter of action, as we approach 4 minutes played, passes it to Perry. Tries in the post. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two.
Yeah, he absorbed the foul and had a chance to knock it down.
And that's all you can ask right there. I like that play.
Number 22. Two shots.
You got me, no problem.
And he makes the first. And so he makes both from the line.
Help out, help out.
Number five hits the three-point bomb. 15 points in the game. Launches a three. That is good. And the first half ends in a close one. The home team, they're up by five. And we'll be back for the second half following the break. Keep it right here on 2K Sports.
Now, presented by Sprint.
The weekend is in full swing on a Saturday night. Glad to have you along with us. At the midway point, the home team is playing very well. They're scoring effortlessly. The defense has been completely overmatched. And the visitors still keeping at it. And give them credit defensively, they're boxing out, controlling their defensive backboards. And we'll be heading back to the court for the rest of our coverage as we go to Kevin Harlan, Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and Doris Burke for the second half.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
Beautiful view here flying north of the city of Dallas, Texas, as we welcome you back. Up a three. The shot is off.
And that's a shot you can't pass up. He should knock that down.
Here's Johnson. That's good.
He's one of the best in the league at that. Even with just a tiny sliver, he always seems to find a way to get it up and in.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight. That one misses. Gone 3 of 7 tonight from three-point territory. Pass to Richards.
Oh! Are you kidding me?
That was a power punch right there.
Oh, great.
You know, sort of surprising he goes for a slam that difficult while they're trailing.
Yeah, but still, you know what? A magnificent move to the rim.
Agreed. Guys, look, I don't know what the score is. That's the play we're all going to remember from this game.
He feeds it to Williams. Tries it from nine, and that one's good.
Looked like the defense kind of backed off, and then he took advantage.
Clark, one thing we've seen from these guys is excellent ball movement.
And you love to see that, Kevin. I mean, I love watching unselfish play, and I know Steve enjoys that, too.
Yeah, that's the best part of the game. I mean, a five-man team game where the ball moves has so much unselfish play. It's beautiful to watch.
Pass to Montgomery. Shoots. That one wide left.
I'll tell you what, for what's really an elementary shot, he looked a little nervous on that release.
The good-looking shot from the wing. He's got five.
Nothing but money for him to start the half. They've made all three of their shot attempts.
Number five. He's guarded by Williams. Smooth as silk on the finger roll.
That finish brings me back to the old days, the silky smooth finger roll.
Third quarter of play with just over a minute and a half gone by. Number 33, defended by Montgomery. And he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up.
Shooting for Dallas. Number 33. At the line for two.
First free throw is good. Good as he hits both of his shots. Gone 2-4 here to start the second half. Ball's knocked loose. It's Brooks on the wing. Wide open. There's the bucket. Good. .152 left to play in the third. Kicks to Williams. Defended by Richards. Williams gets the bucket. Williams has got his third bucket of the night.
They've done a lot of good work with the ball. Really moving both the ball and moving bodies, getting quality chances at the hoop.
And they're not wasting chances when they get them. I mean, they're hitting their shots.
Number 10. That three off target had some space there after the little pump fake. Here's the break. A finish. To post dunk.
Straight to the bucket with a nice head of steam.
Well, no reason to slow it down when there's nothing in the way.
Third quarter here, and 3 minutes have come off the clock. Pass to Williams. Zero. It's blocked. It's off his leg. And it's whistled a kick. There's 48 seconds left in the third quarter of the game. But he recovers it. Number 33. Right through the D for the layup. He's got eight.
He was the first one to react to that miss. Excellent anticipation on his part. A hustle play on the putback by him.
puts up a three. And yes, sir, that one drops. 32 seconds left in the third quarter. Fade away, and the shot is good.
Well, I think he shot the ball well, guys, but I don't think he shot it enough. The more shots he gets from here on out, the more they'll stretch out this lead.
Number five, defended by Sutton. Number three, misses the finger roll. Shots continuing to fall as we conclude the third quarter. Both teams putting up points. The home team up eight. And after a quick break, we're going to come right back with the start of the fourth quarter. And the final period of play just about to start. Gone 6 of 8 on three-pointers in the game, an outstanding 75% mark. Passes it to Perry on the wing. Johnson. Drilled from 11 feet out.
And this game is really heated up. I didn't think it could get any more high scoring than it already was.
Well, there's always room for more offense, Steve. You know that.
From 11 feet away, Montgomery uses the glass to finish the layup.
I tell you what, the defenders didn't even get a sniff of him on that move to the hoop.
Being a mind-boggling 79% off the floor. Number 30 gets it to go from beyond the arc.
And that kind of defense is just not going to cut it, guys. I mean, they have to get a hand in his face.
Shoots the three. No good. Gone 7-9 on three-pointers tonight. Outstanding mark from long range. Number 23. Great look, but off the mark. Doing so well, 63% the offense working as one cohesive unit. That's good.
Absolutely. On fire from beyond the arc.
Yeah, that's where he's getting his points.
Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
Hi, guys. I got a chance to hear what the home team head coach was saying to his players. He was absolutely adamant, saying, don't let them off the hook. Let's keep our foot on the pedal and keep doing the things that have gotten us here this far. We're almost home.
He kicks it to Williams. A baseline J, and there's the rejection. And the ball ends up out of bounds. They'll keep possession. We've gone about a minute and a half into the fourth quarter. For three.
Well, he looks like he wants to toy around with some of their sets and matchups here.
You know, I don't think you can afford to go through a whole game doing the same thing over and over, and you have to be able to adjust on the fly, just like he's doing here.
Just over a minute and a half played here in the fourth. Pass to Richards. And he banks in the layup.
Nice pass. He got the ball right into his teammate's shooting pocket. On time and on target.
Gone 2-4 from the field since we started the final quarter of play. Williams gets the bucket. Number five, defended by Sutton. Number five, and the basket good. 20 points for him.
His shooting has been so good today, he may have to take it upon himself to try to get his club out of this hole.
The pass to Sutton. It's good with the assist that time from Johnson.
That was some skill there. Nice use of the bounce pass.
Gone to the three-pointer 11 times tonight, nailed 5 of them. Number 3. And right on target. Good. We're in the fourth quarter here, just under 2.5 minutes gone. He couldn't stay in bounds, and that's going to be a turnover.
I'll tell you what, wandering aimlessly out of bounds like that might earn him a ticket to the bench.
Away, fires the three, can't get it to go. On 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Off his leg, and the ref's whistling a kickball. Just about 3 minutes through the fourth quarter here. Front pass the arc.
I think the game plan needs to change here, guys, if they're going to get out of the hole, because he is not helping their offense.
And he gets it to go as they call the foul. He's on his way to the line for one more.
Well, you got to like his shot selection today. He set a good example for the rest of his teammates.
Shooting for Dallas. Johnson. At the line for one.
Going 5 of 8 shooting as we've come down the home stretch in this final quarter. He passes to Montgomery. And goaltending is going to be the call. So they get the basket there anyway.
He almost got to that shot in time, but not quite. You can't touch the ball once it's on the way down.
A lot of noise coming from these fans. Pretty unhappy with that call.
Well, you know, we've got a lot of amateur officials in the crowd, and not one of them liked it.
But he tried to step in and cut him off, so he's just not quick enough.
And we have the benefit of replay, but I think they got that one right, which is the case most times, even though fans don't think so.
And the first of two, no good, heartbreaker. That's good, going 1-2 from the line, and that stretches their lead to 8.
Not as productive a trip to the line as he would have liked, but they're still in a pretty comfortable position.
And down it goes. Dunked through off a wonderful assist. No challenge from the defense there, but could have put that one through any way he wanted.
And I love the choice there, partner. Going hard to the hoop for that throwdown.
Yeah, that's invisible defense leading to a very visible finish.
At the line for two.
He doesn't hit the first, and that was the one they really wanted. He's got one more, though. He's able to hit the second one, and that makes it a 7-point lead. A look at the clock, a little under 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth. Number 3. His three-pointer's off the mark. Gone 7 of 10 shooting from three-point land tonight. Excellent numbers from outside. Feeds it to Williams. The feather touch on the finger roll. Beautiful.
Just look at how quickly their lead has grown over the course of the last few possessions.
Boy, they've really saved their best for last, haven't they?
What's your take, guys?
Well, talk all they want, but I just don't see a way for them to get back into the game here.
You know what? I don't know if there's a 10-point play out there, and that being the case, this one is finay. Over.
Over 3.5 minutes through the final quarter now. And he takes that one up and powers it through.
You know, he's not your typical NBA center in terms of height, guys, but he plays as big as any of them, thanks to his incredible bounceability.
We've got 13 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Number 22. And the bucket counts, and he's on his way to the free throw line. Trying to make it a three-point play.
Time to turn out the lights on this game.
I think they deserve a ton of credit for the way they played here today. Truly a professional display.
At the line for your Mavericks, number 22. One shot.
And that ought to do it. I think any chance for a miracle comeback just went out the window with those free throws.
And so the home crowd treated to a win. They put on a show tonight, thoroughly controlling each end of the floor.
Hey, what more can you ask?
And that'll do it for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke. This is Kevin Harlan saying so long and thanks for joining us as we leave you with the Jordan Player of the Game.
Started from the bottom, now my whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we here.